So we're talking about income inequality, right? Starting off with, we're talking about India. In India, the actual wealth of India is 224 trillion. So if the actual wealth of India is actually divided among all the families of India, what do you think would be the actual share of each family? The actual share of each family would be somewhere around 9 lakh rupees. Is it what we are getting? No. About what are the possible causes of this income inequality? The first one is trade liberalization. There are three major reasons for trade liberalization that has caused inequality in income rates. First is labor market outcome, second is globalization, and third is the technological changes. Second, we're talking about changes in the taxation laws. So there have been some political policy reforms, regressive taxation policy has come into picture, and there has been a discriminative access to education. Now let's talk about inequalities in other sectors, which is, say, a gender pay gap or wealth concentration among the 1% of the population. Going forward, we're talking about what is the growth factor, the highly unequal asset distribution. So income is derived from two sources, namely the assets that are land, cattle, share, etc., and second is the labor. In India, very few chunk own these sources of income, that is the earning assets. Some others who do not own or have a part of their asset, they operate, organize these finances through banks, cooperatives, etc., and finally acquire or hire productive resources. These inequalities in the distribution of the earning assets enable few to get the income in the form of rent, interest, and profit. Now, as these assets accumulate and pass on from generations to generations, the earning capacity of these increases continuously. As for the rural areas, the ownership pattern of the most important assets, that is land, is highly unequal. Now, what this leads to, so let's take an example. The marginal household with a holding less than 1 hectare, which accounts to as many as 72% of the rural population own very little, that is 17% of the land. Now, there are also large holdings that are more than 10 hectares who are as much as 1% of the rural household, but they have their ownership of about 14% of the area. Going forward, we're talking about differential regional growth as an important factor. Of the many bottom rungs of income, a very large proportion is in the poor backward state region, most of which very few are in the high income state region. This is the geographical facet of income inequality for a country like India as a whole. Within the states also, there is inequality present, perhaps larger in the poor states and comparatively smaller in the bigger states. Now, these aspects are the outcome of different growth rates of these states, with few states having faster growth rate and many having a lag behind growth rate. There's also inadequate employment generation. People at the bottom could not raise their economic status and to an extent reduce the distance separating them from the top if they could get work, but they could not. In other words, they do not possess the adequate earning assets that they could earn from their labor. Implications of this inequality on various economic factors. First is the health and social cohesion. First, the higher rate of health and social problems in unequal states, that is obesity, mental illness, homicides, teenage birth, child conflict, and drug, lower rates of social good expectancy rates, and an inverse link between income inequality and social cohesion. In a more equal society, people are more likely to trust each other, enjoying the benefits of goodwill, fellowship with lower homicide rate. This will have a huge implication on the economic growth of the country. Now let's talk about population health. The inequality and social stratification lead to higher levels of sociological stress and status anxiety, which will lead to depression, chemical dependency, less community life, parental problems, and stress diseases. Another problem, another ramification is crime. The tendency for violence may be common in societies where income differences are larger. About half of the variation in the homicide rates are accounted by differences in the amount of inequality in each region.